Welcome to the Pyramid Air Holiday Gift Guide for 2018, guys. Today's topic, tactical air rifles for the tactical air gunner in your life. I'm your host, Tactical Tyler. Let's get into it. First up, guys, a classic at this point, the SIG MCX. Now, there's also the MPX, which is the unshrouded version, has a little bit more of a bark to it, but these guys use an 88 gram CO2 cartridge, or you can pick up that Air Venturi 13 cubic inch HPA bottle if you wanna run it on high pressure air, great for that wintertime shooting you might be doing. But guys, this has all the hallmarks of the real steel version that SIG puts out, the MCX. You got your flip up metal sights, you have a realistic charging handle that actually cocks the rifle. You have obviously your safety selector switch running you in safe and semi-automatic only. And the big difference between this and a lot of the others that are out there, this guy is a pellet repeater. Semi-automatic, as fast as you can pull the trigger, with 30 round belts inside of this magazine. It's a lot of fun to shoot. Up next, guys, one of my favorites. We reviewed this earlier this year in 2018, the Crossman DPMS SBR. Awesome little BB rifle, obviously fully automatic with that capability, semi-auto as well. 25 round magazine, two CO2 cartridges, spitting out BBs just as fast as you pull the trigger. And the best feature, in my opinion, you have that realistic blowback actually working that bolt housing inside of there. This gun's got a great feel to it, and having that feel of that recoil, it's nothing like it. This is an awesome gun, and now available in flat dark earth as well if you're interested. Check it out. Now, for those of you that might like a more traditional M4 or AR style look to a gun, you have the Hellboy here, which we also reviewed this year. A nice little BB offering here, interesting magazine design that actually drops free, which a lot of the other ones don't do, and largely a full metal housing here with the exception of the handguard and the buttstock. Pretty nice little gun, good trigger on this guy, semi-auto only, which I suppose is a little bit of a drawback, but good velocity up to 500 feet per second out of this one, and you can certainly take the scope or the rail off here, mount a scope on it or a red dot if you want to. This guy's got a lot of customization features as well. If you take off that handguard, you can put on whatever you want. The Hellboy is definitely one to check out this holiday season as well. Now, the only PCP to grace our list, guys, is the Benjamin Armada. Now, when this guy came out, this caught a lot of eyes because of the tactical look to it, of course. With your standard kind of AR buttstock as well as your grips, you can take this off, put your real steel AR furniture on here if you want to, if you've got a favorite. But a bolt action PCP, a 10 shot repeater in 22, 8 shots in 25, those are the two calibers it's available in. You're talking about 30 foot pounds in 22, up to 45 in 25. Very, very quiet with the shrouded barrel as well, 3000 PSI fill. The Armada is a venerable classic at this point, but definitely one you should be looking at if you are looking for that more tactical look out of a PCP rifle. Now, we've got a couple CO2 pistols for you guys. One of the newer ones that's recently come out here, the H&K USP. This is a great looking gun, obviously replicates the real thing to a T. This gun looks, feels great. You got the polymer frame with the metal upper, the slide there. Does lock back, full blowback, of course. You have your paddle style release for the magazine, and you got a big old magazine there to add that real weight to it. Another cool little feature. So you do have your safety selector switch, of course, but it also, you flip it all the way down, decocker as well. So really realistic replica coming out of Umarex here for that HK USP, which is probably one of the more common service pistols around the world. So definitely check this one out. It just came out, one to look at. Next up, a BB replica of probably the most popular handgun in America and probably the world over, the Glock 19. Now, this guy is a non-blowback BB replica here, so you have that stick-style drop BB magazine. Does have a really nice feel in the hand to it. I'm not a huge fan of the safety on the trigger, but other than that, guys, this feels just like the Glock 19 I have at home sitting on my nightstand. Really nice feel in the hand. Has that realistic loaded weight to it. And certainly something that if you're looking to get that realistic training or practice in at home, Glock 19 is going to be one you want to look at. Last but certainly not least, guys, the SIG M17. It is the newest gun here on the table, and of course you're probably familiar with it because it is the gun that the U.S. Army is going to be using now, just won their contract. So this is obviously a big one for SIG, and to have a replica so quickly of this gun is really actually quite awesome. The gun's very modular. You can actually strip basically the entire thing down. But what's different about this guy than the other pistols on the table here is that this is a pellet repeater, which is very cool. And just looking at the magazine, so you have your standard style 20 round belt magazine that goes in here with a little bit different CO2 loading system. I don't want to say more complex, but certainly a little bit different. And you get that nice extended frame there, just like you do on the real steel M17. There may even be an optic available for this in the future if you want to run a red dot on it. So a lot of really unique features, things we haven't seen before here that SIG's really pushing in this M17, which is part of the 320 family. Thanks for joining us today, guys, as we ran down our top 7 tactical picks for the holiday season. Don't forget to like, comment down below. Let us know if you have one of these guns, what you think of them, which one you're going to be picking up over the holidays. And don't forget to, as always, subscribe. I've been your host, Tactical Tyler. We'll see you guys at the next one.